like a bleeding fiddler's elbow.
Now shut it and listen to this.
Brian Frederick Fisher, a dead ringer for the geezer we want. That's Fisher, S-C-H. Previous includes auto theft, obtaining by deception, demanding money with menaces, etc., etc.
One of the biggest cop shows of the 70s is back in fashion, and that means cult status for the dashing John Thor and Dennis Waterman. So we decided to pull one of them in for questioning. The word is that Dennis Waterman's on the streets of Norwich, and when you're looking for a man from the Sweeney, you've just got to have the right equipment. Kevin here is off to track him down.
Oi you, get in.
In fact, Dennis Waterman is in Norwich with the play Killing Time. He stars alongside Glynis Barber in the thriller at the Theatre Royal.
Aren't you going to answer the phone?
No, let it ring.
You'll lose all your friends if you don't answer your calls.
What are you doing?
What the hell did you do that for? I only picked up the phone.
It's my phone.
For the former Detective Sergeant Carter, it's a world away from the flying squad.
It's very, very successful, I have to say. I mean, it's smashing. There's just two of us in it, Glynis Barber and myself, and you know, when you start on a tour, you just don't know what it's going to be like, and the bookings are huge, and we're having a really good time. And it's quite a good play.
The Sweeney was made between 1974 and 1978. It earned a reputation for being tough and uncompromising in its look at life among the men who dealt with London's most ruthless criminals. But in the last year, it's taken off again. As well as the reruns, there's a TV commercial and even a Sweeney website on the internet.
I think the advert's very funny. It makes me laugh, I must say. And the Sweeney, I mean, it just, you know, it was kind of groundbreaking at the time. And it's just interesting to see that it does still hold up. I mean, the clothes and everything and the hairstyles are all a bit strange. But I think the stories and the action, you know, really, you know, we were very lucky. We had great script writers and we had good directors.
Go now.
You know, it was the first filmed cop show here, I think. And we smoked and drank and we lost cases and we weren't perfect in any means. And it was, and the real police, who we knew lots of, I mean, their biggest worry that it was too true to life. But I tell you, this was interesting, being in the Granada, because it was the only time I've ever sat in the front. That's for DIs, you see. I was a detective sergeant. They wouldn't let me in the front.
Anyway, Regan and Carter may be gone, Dennis Waterman is still going strong.
And as for you, come on, get on with it, will you?
I don't know, but I'll tell you.
The new thriller, Killing Time, is at the Chelmsford Civic Theatre from October the 13th to the 18th.
What else happened to Michael? Come on, come on. What else happened to him?
Aren't you going to answer the phone?
No, let it ring.
You'll lose all your friends if you don't answer your calls.
What are you doing?
What the hell did you do that for? I only picked up the phone.
It's my phone.
Well, you didn't have to break my arm.
I didn't want to take the call.
Well, you hurt me.
You answered my phone.
Well, I didn't mean any harm by it.
Yeah, and I didn't mean to hurt you.
Well, it's the time I left.
No. No, please stay.
Glynis, what's the storyline behind Killing Time? Well, why do I always get the difficult questions?
Because you're more intelligent than
I am. Oh, right, well, true.
And you've read it.
Well, that's also true, yes. Well, it's, I can't tell too much because I don't want to give the story away. But basically, it's two people who, well, he basically picks me up in Tesco's, right? Mm-hmm. And I've lost my purse. He helps me out, pays for my shopping. I give him a lift home. I come in, seemingly innocent encounter, and then it sort of goes from there.
Are you enjoying working with each other?
Yeah, it's good, thank you, yeah.
Well, we can't really say anything else in front of each other, can we?
We'll do the private interviews later.